smile for the camera.
You
there.
Look like your dad. People probably tell you that every time you say something.
Yeah, he doesn't smile that much, though.
See a hockey
player. He's smiling tonight, though.
So, well, what are the emotions? I mean, you clinched, and it's been an unusual ride, but you're right back where you were a year ago. This time.
Well, it feels great. You know, I thought we played a really good game besides the one shorthanded goal against, but guys worked hard, and the guys were really bonding on the bench. I thought everyone was into the game. We were patting each other on the back, and it was nice to see that when you see that happen on the bench, you know you got something special with your team. So that was a good win for us.
You enter the playoffs, it'll be different this year, won't it? Because last year there was all that pressure of never having won and having such a powerhouse team. Will it feel different?
I think it's always pressure to win. So, everyone wants to win, and that's our goal. And we got, we established the first now in the conference. And you just got to keep doing what you're doing well and learn from it and get better every game, and hopefully we can do it again.
How much does your championship history, several guys obviously have won one, will that help in the playoffs, do you think?
I think so. I think when you know what it takes to win and, you play the right way, you have a lot of character in your team, and those guys will hopefully lead the younger guys and the other players who haven't won one to play the right way and what we have to do to win. So.
Say late February, I would have said you go 15-2-1 and finish first in the East. Would you have thought that a realistic turn of events?
No, I think I've been saying no all year. I didn't realize if that's a correct stat. I didn't even know we were that. So, but it's been a good ride. It's been rewarding for me as a coach to see these guys play well and see where they're at right now in the standings. And but we haven't won it again, so we just got to continue to play well and hopefully do it again.
Have you had a chance to digest sort of the history that you're making here? With all, I mean, you're setting franchise records, and since you've taken over, you lead the Eastern Conference in wins as a franchise. Can you digest that sort of stuff yet?
Really, I haven't looked at it. Maybe I should put it on my resume.
Yeah,
I didn't realize that. So, I'm happy. Of course, Reading's been good to me, and the city, the fans, everyone's really treated me really well, the organization. So, I'm happy to be with this club, and hopefully at some point I'd like to move on to the American League, of course, and get to the NHL, but right now I'm extremely happy, and I just want to continue working with these guys and try to make them better players.
Do you think this is a feather in your cap as your evolution as a coach, that you've been able to adapt with this team and turn it into the same results?
Well, I just think that I've learned from every year how this league works, and I work hard over the summer to try to get quality people in here, and that's one of the biggest things I try to do is make sure I get prepared in the summer that, we have a good start and we have a good team here. And if I don't think you do that, work hard enough. It's like the stuff on the ice. If you don't work hard enough, you're not going to get the results. So we just try to do our best and get quality people in here, and it's been successful for us.
You've alluded to teams get loaded from the A at the end a lot, and you probably won't. Is that your biggest concern going into the beginning of the playoffs?
Well, I don't say it's a big concern of mine, but it's always, you want to see how your team's going to be in the end of the playoffs. But this team has been resilient all year with the players that we've had, with the call-ups that we've had, the injuries, and they just seem to find a way. So, hopefully we'll continue that process.
Part of you probably doesn't want to change a thing, right? Because
it's hard when you're winning, right? So, when things are working the right way, it's when you start to lose, you got to make some tough decisions on, how we change and who goes in, who goes out. So, right now we're happy. We'll definitely make some lineup changes to Florida next week. Get some younger guys in, like the Williamson kid from Bowling Green will definitely play, and probably send a couple older guys out to kind of keep them fresh for the playoffs.
That's going to be a tough trip, isn't it, going to Florida with nothing really on the line? Are you concerned at all about keeping guys focused on the
You always do when you go out to those cities, but like I said, we had a great bunch of guys there, so and good leadership, so I'm sure they'll be fine.
Do you have a Gill status? Or?
I don't know. He'll be evaluated. I think he's got the flu. And
it wasn't the clue. Oh, he's got the flu.
So
you might need a goalie for last.
Yeah, I've already made a call to Washington for a goaltender, so we'll see what happens here in the next couple of days.
You have three games now, which is really kind of a luxury to do what you want to with.
Yeah.
What do you plan on doing it down in Florida that's different than if you'd be fighting for the conference?
Well, the biggest thing is you'll see younger guys get more opportunity to play a lot more ice time. Some of our older guys will sit out. We want to get Nick in the lineup a little more, give him a little more ice time, maybe the power play, the defenseman that we brought in, and definitely Williamson. And then that's really about it. I think we want to, you know, we still want to play the right way and win, of course, because we want to continue our confidence of going into the playoffs. But that's where the changes I'll make.
When is the, what's the date for the playoff roster?
April 14th.
April 14th. Okay. Saw your parents were in town last night. It was nice to meet them upstairs, by the way.
Thank you.
Does it feel special to you know, win this all with your son here, with your family in town?
For sure. You know, my family's always been a big supporter of my career, so it's always nice when they come down. I don't get to see them very often. And, you know, I'm sure they're pretty proud of my, you know, the success the team has done and what we've had. So it's always nice to see.
They told me they watch all the games on our recliners on
I think USA. My mom takes notes all the time too. So.
Oh.
Yes, they may be the next coach. We'll see. But yeah, they've always supported me, and it's great to see them here.
How does it feel? It's quite an accomplishment to go back-to-back winning the regular season.
It's awesome. I mean, there's nothing better than winning. That's why, in my opinion, I think in pro hockey, the only measuring stick you really have is winning. So to accomplish our goal, it's one of the things we set out for at the beginning of the year. Feels great, and now we're kind of feeling like we're only getting started. So we'll kind of enjoy this one for a couple days here and then finish some more games off on the road trip.
Can you appreciate how difficult an achievement it is, especially in the Eastern Conference where there are 13 teams? I mean, to do it 2 years in a row is pretty amazing.
Yeah, you know, I think you look back on the season and you reflect, and you know, there's some games here and there where you kind of think, man, how did we pull those out, or games where you should have won and you didn't. Unfortunately, you know, we've been kind of having the right kind of work ethic the entire year. Even with guys up, guys injured, and rosters depleted at moments, you know, a lot of guys stepped up. So I can't say enough about the guys we have in that locker room. It's been a tremendous team effort, especially this last weekend playing Orlando for the first time, and KZU. They're two really strong teams.
To run through that, all three, to win those three games.
Yeah, and the way we did it, I mean, you know, we don't like being behind in the first period, but for whatever reason, we found ourselves in that quite a bit this year. So we're comfortable there, and we know we can do it. So, you know, hopefully we can tighten things up a bit going forward. But we're comfortable where we are. No matter what, we stick together, and I think that's kind of a tribute to the coaching staff and the leaders on the team.
Last year, the team was so good, and you were wire to wire, and it was all about playoffs from, like, February, you know. Does it feel different this year in the sense that you're kind of, it's like a late rush that you're making, and the expectations might not be as high?
It is. I think our expectations are just as high. I think
internally,
you know, I mean, every team wants to win. That's our ultimate goal. I think we put ourselves in a good position. But I think whereas last year we realized we had a championship caliber team early on, especially with the amount of guys we were getting back from Hershey and different clubs and whatnot. You know, this year we've realized it. I don't know if we realized it as early as last year, but I think collectively as a group we're in a really good place.
And does having won it last year help?
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, there's only a handful of guys in that room that were on the team last year. You know, it's a different makeup. But that's positive. That's the way this league goes. That's the way every team is. No team's ever going to be the same. It's kind of the fun part about our league. But we've got guys in the room who have done it before and guys who are buying in and willing to buy in. So it's something special.
Is part of you pinch yourself and go, man, I'm in first place? I mean, it's like everywhere you go, it's first place.
Yeah.
Is success following you?
I think I'm the benefactor of good coaches and good teams.
I mean, you're part of it, though. I mean, you in Alaska, you were in first place before you got traded here, so really, it's every year of your career.
Yeah, I think it's a tribute to team identities that we have. I know me personally, I can only control what I can control, and hopefully some guys pick up on that and follow or step up and lead alongside me, you know. So I think it's sometimes I pinch myself, but then I look back and I look at the guys who are on our team, I look at our coaches, and it's a whole group effort for my last 4 years, so it's awesome.
You're going to Florida for three games that won't matter in the standings.
They always matter.
Well,
let's talk here. They always matter. I know mathematics.
Will make no difference.
But yeah.
That's a little, I mean, you get a little sun. You worried about that at all?
No. We're all professionals, and you know, I know there's some young guys, especially some call-ups and some college kids who Larry's wanting to see. So we'll kind of see how it goes. You know, us in Florida don't really get along too well, so those are two big games that we want to win. And you always want to be on the right foot going into playoffs.
You also wrecked their playoff hopes. games too.
Yeah.
If you want to.
That's
beat them now instead of beating them in the playoffs.
Absolutely. Why take care of something tomorrow if you can take care of it today? So.
How do you impress on the young guys that are in, that just come in now, the character that you want on the team?
I think it's just consistency. You know, there's a difference between continually being on someone and hounding them, and just making sure that they're prepared. You know, I think if you have a someone who's mentally strong, they're going to buy in and get it right away. And I think so far we have Wolf. Wolfie has come and has done a tremendous job. You know, Brew, who played the last two games, done a great job too, stepping on that.
But I mean, like, you guys believe you can come back. How do you get them to believe what you believe?
Well, I think it's just contagious. Once everyone, if everyone's buying in, there's not going to be one guy not doing it. And if one guy kind of loses track, it's obvious, and everyone collectively comes together and makes sure they're on board.
Going to playoffs in first place, I think it's a statement to everyone else, and it's a testament to the way that we've come together and the way that we're working together.
It seems like teams sometimes, they just get in this groove and they start to feel this invincibility, like you're just going to win night in and night out. Is that kind of how this team feels right now?
I wouldn't go as far as saying, you know, invincible hockey's a crazy game and there are ups and downs, but I think as a group, we're confident in ourselves in the dressing room and in crucial games, like last night and tonight, where when the times are when it's getting down to it, we're doing a good job, and like I said, everybody's just pushing that little bit extra and digging deep, and I think everyone's doing a good job.
And to win three against Orlando and Kalamazoo in 4 days, I mean, that's about as good of a playoff test as you can have, right? Mm-hmm. That's basically the same thing as you'll have to do in the next few weeks.
Yeah, absolutely. I think the way our schedules worked out right before the playoffs had started, it worked in our favor, even though I think it's good that we're facing those tougher teams, those more competitive teams, because those are going to be the realistic games that we're going to be facing down the stretch. So I think it's a good test for everyone right before we head into the playoffs.
Is that shot, did you ever think that was going to get through, or when you take those, is it just see where it goes?
Well, I had about four shin pads earlier in the game, so I was due for one. Yeah, Deeks told me, he said, just keep shooting, man, you'll get one of them through. But no, on that one, actually, early in the shift, I hit a shin pad, and I was able to pick this one up. They did a good job of coming out at first, and I just stepped to the middle, and I saw a lane, and our guys did a great job of taking away the goalie's eyes. So I, even while I was going there, I saw that the goalie, I couldn't see it because our guys were doing a good job of screening.
So you got some posts too. Does it still, yeah, you have to call, yeah, bank, like, no, basketball?
Yeah, that's right. I said I didn't want to put it right. I want to keep it a little bit exciting for everyone. So I posting in.
And water bottle. Take it. And water bottle.
Oh, and a water bottle. You got to mix that in there too, so it's good.
How does it feel being on a team like this that's just believes it can win?
It's good.
No matter what.
It's good. It's definitely a good thing. You know, like I said earlier, I think everyone's been doing a really good job, and we were meshing at the right time. Last couple of games, we faced some pretty competitive teams, and they've been pretty good tests to us. And we really come together, and we're pushing each other at the right time.
Does a team feel like that? Going down to Florida, they can knock Florida out early. You know, they have a chance to really do that.
If we keep doing what we're doing, I think we'll be successful. I think that's no matter what teams we're coming up against, you know, as long as we play the way that we play, I think we'll be, I think we'll be set. We just need to keep doing those little things like we've been doing and working hard.